So, always keep a jump jet handy.
First, you'll want to talk to the Nexus logistics officer to coordinate food and water supplies.
Do we offload what we've brought?
See how much food they've managed.
All stasis personnel, report to duty station.
Captain wants to see a full duty roster.
I just updated the charts.
I want to see crew reassignments first.
Start with non-essential personnel.
Okay, folks. This is what we've been waiting for. Let your teams know.
Engineering reports that Nexus coupling is underway.
It'll be nice to see some friendly faces this time.
The Nexus runs a support crew, just enough to finish building the station and provide safe harbor for the Arcs.
Means we can start waking our people up.
They built a bar, right? Gotta have champagne for the welcome party.
You're expecting one?
After what we've been through, I could use a buzz.
We all could.
Yeah. Rough ride so far.
We'll bounce back. Real food and a shower are just ahead. Here we are.
I don't see any champagne.
Where is everybody? Well, this can't be right.
It's like everything's on standby.
If it's a surprise party, they're doing an awfully good job of it.
We could see what the VI has to say.
Welcome to the Nexus, gateway to Andromeda. I'm Avena, a virtual intelligence designed to assist you with immigration.
Can you tell us where the welcome party is hiding?
I'm sorry. My code is limited to information and simple interaction simulations. Please select from the following pre-programmed responses.
What year is it?
The current year is 2819. After spending over 600 years in stasis, it's normal to feel disoriented or confused upon arrival. Our helpful medical staff can assist with any physical or psychological after effects you may be experiencing.
Well, she's got the date right, at least.
So where is everyone? What is the Nexus?
The Nexus serves as the central hub for the Andromeda Initiative's colonization efforts. It is the first destination for all colonists upon their arrival in the new galaxy. Please enjoy the many venues the Nexus has to offer. As the station expands, it will one day serve as the seat of government for Milky Way colonists. Providing a safe, stable, and prosperous environment is our primary goal.
Not from the looks of it.
How does the immigration process work?
We ask that you submit to a brief medical exam to ensure your health and well-being after making such a long journey. Once you've been cleared, our colonization experts will assist you in finding your new home. Please be mindful of the queue. Thousands of eager colonists like you are waiting to begin their new life in Andromeda.
Where? Place is deserted.
What can you tell me about the Andromeda Galaxy?
Here in Andromeda, you are over 2 million light-years away from the Milky Way galaxy. This is the furthest any life form has ever traveled outside our home system, making you a brave pioneer indeed. The Nexus itself is located in a region known as the Helios Cluster. Here, you and thousands of your fellow colonists will fulfill your dreams of settling a new home. Fortune awaits.
That's all.
It has been my pleasure. Please see one of our helpful immigration staff for further assistance. And welcome to your new home in Andromeda, where the brightest star is you. Current wait time for immigration processing is... unknown error.
Right. That was helpful.
Plants are still alive.
Like they didn't finish building it.
Hello?
Hi there. We're from Arc Hyperion, and wondering where everybody went.
Did he hear you?
Did you say an Ark? Yeah, we just got in.
And for what it's worth, your VI over there could use an update.
But we thought you were all dead.
What?
Or captured, or lost in dark space, or... But you're here. You have no idea how much this means.
I don't believe it. I'm Tyrion Kandros. I lead our militia on the Nexus.
I'm Scott Ryder. This is Cora Harper and Liam Costa, part of the Pathfinder team.
I'm sorry for the confusion. Our sensors told us an Ark had arrived, but Helios is notorious for scrambling equipment. We thought you were just another malfunction.
Well, I've got a shipload of people that says we're here.
Of course, it's just... you're the first Ark we've seen. After a year of waiting and no sign of the others, we shuttered this area and stopped looking.
You've been stranded for a whole year?
Longer. I'll fill you in on the way to Op Center. Everything that could go wrong with our plan has. We arrived 14 months ago. Right away, we hit a band of dark energy that knocked us off course.
We're familiar with it.
Then you'll know why we call it the Scourge. We lost whole sections of the station. A lot of people died. No power, no food. The chaos went on for months. It finally led to armed rebellion. When order was restored, the insurgents were banished. Exiles, we call them.
Are things back to normal?
Not even close. But you're here now, so maybe the worst is over.
No word from the other Pathfinders?
No word from anyone, period.
Any threats from the locals?
So far, we've stayed hidden. We're in no shape to deal. We're here.
You guys go ahead. I'll check out the security situation.
You should know our command structure has been fractured. Some of us are filling in for leaders who died.
Is it true?
They said drop everything and report for duty.
And no one was expecting an Ark to finally show up.
Docking procedures are green across the board.
Stand by to merge Hyperion power into the grid.
The crew of the Hyperion.
Good luck.
I'm Jaren Tan, director of the initiative. You have no idea how much your arrival means to us.
Not as much as it means to us. We had one hell of a time getting here. Nice to see some friendly faces.
Hungry faces. Any supplies you can spare would be appreciated.
This is Foster Addison. She oversees colonial affairs. Where's the Pathfinder?
You're looking at him.
You're not Alec Ryder.
My father's dead. He made me his successor.
Alec is dead. Please understand, the entire initiative is at risk. None of the Golden Worlds panned out. They're a bust, and there's been no word from the other Arks.
What happened to them?
Unknown. Our supplies are nearly depleted. Rationing bought us some time, but even that's running out.
We need to find more resources, but that takes people, and we can't wake them up.
Until they have somewhere to live. A golden world.
Now more than ever, we need a Pathfinder.
It now falls to you, Ryder. Are you up to the task?
My father believed I am. If you trusted him with a job, you'll have to trust his judgment.
Your father won't be around to fix things if you fail.
That's no way to treat a guest. I'm Nakmor Kesh, superintendent of this station. Hope they haven't scared you off already.
It's nothing personal, but now isn't the time for on-the-job training.
At least the Pathfinder here seems willing to try. We could use a fresh perspective.
You've heard my concerns. I'll leave you to it.
We're all feeling the pressure. Let's have a private word in my office, Ryder. We'll discuss giving you a scoutship. I'm happy to work out the details with your associate.
Welcome to the Nexus.
Thank you for standing up for me there.
Hope's in short supply here. What little we can find should have a chance.
Ma'am, the Hyperion's core is now online.
Let me show you something. An hour ago, that was all dark. But with the power from your ship, you're keeping the lights on. You have my vote.
And when the power runs out?
You'd best go talk to Director Tan. Make sure that doesn't happen. And don't be shy. Come see me when you have a chance.
Engineering reports. Hyperion power draw is now at 100%.
Hyperion is starting to send a tally of supplies. I'll just organize this as it comes in and send it your way. You know what the
hello, console.
Are anyway.
You and I are going to be very good friends. We'll get you all fixed up and ready to go.
This is the planet where we landed. Habitat 7. It wasn't even close to livable.
That's been true of every world we've found. Ryder, we were discussing your next expedition.
Good. I was starting to wonder who was in charge around here.
Director Addison is entitled to her opinion, and mine overrules hers.
Does she know that?
I oversee the entire initiative, and I have decided to give you a chance to prove yourself. To that end, the Scourge dealt us a serious blow. Whatever it is, our scientists theorize it's not natural.
An artificial energy cloud?
It wasn't here when we left the Milky Way, yet it rendered all the Golden Worlds unlivable. Then there's the aliens you ran into, the Ket. They're obsessed with alien structures we found scattered around the cluster. They'll do anything to prevent others from accessing them. It seems murder isn't exclusive to the Milky Way. And now the challenge is to settle a world in spite of all that. This one here. Eos.
How?
You need to increase the viability of the planet so we can establish an outpost. Then we can bring more colonists out of stasis. The more colonists we have, the more resources we can gather to support the Nexus. Everything depends on it. There are 6 worlds we hope to settle.
Okay. But you said every planet you found is unlivable. So how do I...
A good Pathfinder would relish the challenge of solving it.
Right. I think I should go check on things.
And if I fail, I guess it's no sweat off your back, right? You'll just look for another Pathfinder?
Placing bets on people is part of my job. Some of them pay off. Others...
Just point me to my ship and I'll be out of here.
They're prepping it now in the docking bay. The coordinates for Eos will be in the computer. And when you have a moment, we should discuss the missing arcs.
I was wondering about that.
Something wrong?
Ryder, Kasimi and Samnud on the Hyperion. Your implant needs attention, and we need to discuss a confidential matter.
No, I'm fine.
Control to Hyperion.
No,
it's good to have you here.
But what choice do we have?
Echo.
How the hell should I know?
The docking checklist, shall we?
Spender, you have a job.
All personnel, be aware of any suspicious activity. Security is on heightened alert.
Hey there.
You okay? Those guys really grilled you. And Addison. First Pathfinder they've seen in over a year. All she can do is question your competence?
Yeah. Meeting Addison was... interesting.
She doesn't know you. I do. And you're doing fine.
I appreciate it.
I worked out logistics with Director Tan. They're giving us a ship and crew. He said their best is taking care of it.
I still need to head back to the Ark and check in with Sam.
Sounds good. While you're there, maybe see how your sister's doing.
Engineering update. We are working on accessing more power from the Hyperion.
I'll make it right, Dash.
Legs feeling a little better.
I promise.
Looks like the muscle. Good news is the bone didn't break.
Ryder, good to see you. Damn shame about your dad, though. I'm sorry we couldn't save him.
I'm sure you did everything you could.
Yeah, but still, we lost a Pathfinder on my watch. Doesn't sit right.
My dad knew the danger. Part of the job.
Now I just need to make sure your sister here pulls through.
How's Sarah doing?
Her condition's stable. I see signs of REM activity in the brain, so she's dreaming. Means all the wiring still works.
How'd this happen?
It was dumb luck, really. We hit the Scourge at the worst possible moment, just as the stasis revival was kicking in. It's a vulnerable moment, coming out of a 600-year nap, then wham! Circuits fried and overloaded the neural pathways. Don't worry, I'm on it. We're not losing another Ryder.
That's all, Harry. Thanks.
Don't be a stranger. If anything changes with Sarah, I'll let you know.
Latest about waking.
Hello, Scott. Welcome back to Samnode. I've adjusted my connection to your implant. The headache you experienced before shouldn't reoccur.
Yeah, what was that about? You said we need to discuss something confidential.
You should know certain facts before you leave on your expedition. It seemed best we speak alone.
Sam, if we're going to work together, you can't keep hiding things from me.
Apologies. I am simply following your father's wishes.
What was he keeping secret?
My true capabilities. Alec overrode the implant safety protocols. It allows me unrestricted access to the Pathfinder's physiology.
And that's me now.
And only you. I can act as a force multiplier, dramatically enhancing your motor and neural skills when required. Alec called them profiles. They provide unique tactical augmentation during combat. Your father preferred to keep this fact to himself.
I can understand. People might get the wrong idea. Super soldiers. A computer having control over a human.
Providing an enhancement to the human. It is a symbiotic relationship that benefits both.
What do you get out of it?
Though I'm artificial in design, I am fully sentient. Far beyond what even the Initiative understands.
I don't follow. You're an AI. So what's different?
I am a new form of AI, drawing directly from the human experience. Your implant is my window into the world.
That's pretty amazing.
But beyond what many people will accept, your father knew some would fear it.
Yeah, he's got a point. So what does this mean for the two of us?
I find myself in an unusual position. Though I had access to your father's experiences, there is a gap in my understanding.
How so?
He placed a block on portions of my memory array.
Why?
Perhaps so when you asked me what his plan was, I wouldn't know.
And Dad strikes again.
But not without recourse. The further you explore as a Pathfinder, the more blocks will be removed. Perhaps you should begin in your father's quarters. In the meantime, unless you have more questions, your new ship awaits.
Thanks.
Pathfinder, Captain Dunn said to seal your father's cabin from anyone but you. It's open now.
Printed books?
Reproductions of Lewis and Clark's journals, detailing their expedition in the 19th century.
Explains Dad's interest. They were Pathfinders too.
Your father's first sidearm, a memento of his early Alliance service.
I bet that saw plenty of action.
Halleck's first kill occurred in combat during the First Contact War.
Back when Turians were the enemy. Crazy times. Sam? What was that?
An eidetic trigger, related to your father and the portions of my memory array he locked.
What triggered it?
Halleck tied it to your progression as Pathfinder, not to a location. Puzzling as it may be, my programming is clear. Locating more of these triggers will unlock the memories. One of your father...
The coffee machine Mom got for Dad. He was so busy designing you, needed the caffeine.
I did not realize I owed my existence to a bean.
And now you know what humility feels like. What's on here, Sam?
Your father's personal logs. Several of them are encrypted.
The day is finally here. We're pushing off from Earth. We'll jump through a few relays first, and then we hunker down for the long trip across dark space. It's daunting thinking about all the hopes and dreams aboard the Hyperion. I certainly have my own. I wasn't the husband or father I should have been. Here's hoping 600 years can change a man. Dunn's agreed to a scouting mission on Habitat 7. I'm gearing up now. I'm worried about Sarah. Dr. Tapera says she'll be fine, but she's my daughter. How can I not worry? I hate to leave her like this. It's these moments when you wish you told your children you love them more often. Or ever. Which brings me to the tough part. Kids, if anything happens to me, there are things you're gonna find out. I hope you'll understand.
Ready to see what Tan gave us?
I hear it's something special. Pathfinder en route. How's the ship?
In final checks and looking great.
We won't be long. The way things are going, we'll be on our own out there.
In other words, we're making this up as we go.
We used to call that tactical improvisation. But at least we'll be doing it in style. They call her the Tempest.
Take a closer look.
Let's pick it up a bit, people. We're 14 months late. So you're the one who's making everything happen. Vetra. Vetra Nix. Initiative Wrangler, Provisioner, Gunner, and everything in between. Are we ready? The sooner we get out of here, the better.
You're coming with us?
Yes. Otherwise, there's no way they're letting this ship off the station.
Yeah. Let's go see the rest of Helios.
Hold it, hold it! You're not going anywhere.
Damn it.
Is something wrong?
Director Addison wants to see a complete report of the Tempest's supplies, munitions, and crew.
Director Tan overruled Addison.
The ship's loaded out with equipment for outpost discovery, squarely under Director Addison's purview.
Seen you around. Ben, right? Came here with a family, didn't you? Son still in cryo? I could pull some strings, get him to the front of the line.
Really?
Yeah, really.
They told me he wasn't essential, but I miss him.
I know. I got family too, Ben.
It's done. Addison's gonna kill me.
Nicely done.
Part of the job, Pathfinder. All things considered, it was an easy ask. And right now, you need people tearing down obstacles, not putting up more.
Finally, someone who cares about doing stuff and not just talking about it.
Everything's state-of-the-art. Labs, sensors, exploration gear. Lesser crew, of course. The best in their field.
Glad to see you're doing so well, Scott.
The engine core is based on the Ark's Odyssey drive.
It runs a hell of a lot quieter.
That's Gil Brody. Engineer, mechanic, all-around wrench jockey. We call this the research room. There's space for upgrading equipment, gathering intel.
Router engaged. Securing connection to Tempest.
Welcome aboard, Sam. And Ryder, of course.
All run by Suvi Anwar, our science officer. Your quarters are below. Plenty of space up here to get everyone together. It's all yours. She's light, stealthy, and the fastest ship in her class.
Every plan the Initiative made is out the window. Now it's on us to find the way.
We all came here ready for a challenge. When you're ready to fly, head over to the bridge. Our pilot should have everything good to go.
Better head to the bridge when we're ready to go.